Dear students, welcome to the last session of the chapter Rat Trap. For a quick revision, we said that this story is about a rat trap peddler. A peddler who used to sell rat traps. His life was very bad, very sad, very monotonous. And one day he came with the thought that the whole world was nothing but a huge rat trap. He was happy that he was out of it. But one day he fell into the rat trap and then circumstances happened in such a manner that he was called to the Iron Master's house. Till there we had read, but let us quickly revise all the questions that we have done. The first question was, why was the peddler's life sad and monotonous? The answer was, no family, no friends, then not a profitable business, then ragged clothes, not proper food to eat. He was a petty beggar and a petty thief, and this made his life sad and monotonous. Then why did he compare the whole world to a rat trap? Because he thought that the world trapped people because of the material comforts that it offered, the comforts in the form of riches, joy, shelter, food, heat and clothing. And when people got lured or tempted by those baits, they entered into the rat trap, then the door was snapped off and they were forever caught. That means if they got material comforts in their life, they got used to those comforts. Then they never wanted to come out. So on the contrary, the rat who is full of fear and wants to escape, the people are happy and they never wish to escape. Instead, they crave for more. So this is why he compared the world to a rat trap. Then the third question is, why was this thought so entertaining to him? The answer is very obvious, because he was out of it. And the second thing, the world was not good to him. So thinking bad about the world in this manner, it gave him happiness. It also became a good pastime of his. So three questions we have done. Then the next question, how did the peddler fall into the rat trap? He knocked the door of a crofter's house. He thought that the crofter would not welcome him inside. But the crofter was very happy, and plus he was lonely that day. Lonely, no family, no friends, and happy because he had earned 30 kroners. He wanted to show and share that happiness with somebody. He welcomed this vagabond inside the house, shared his happiness with him, and even shared the secret and told him, even in unconsciously, unknowingly, he told him the place also where the money was kept. The peddler stole the money, and next day he said thank you, but he did not mean that thank you. He stole the hard-earned money of the crofter and ran away. Then the next question is, what were his first emotions? His first emotions were of happiness that he could steal the money, and the second emotion was of fear that the 30 kroners should not be taken away from him. He entered a forest. So then with this, the next question comes, how did and when did he realize that he had fallen into a rat trap? It was when he got lost in the forest. He tried to find a way out, but he could not. And then he realized that he had fallen into the rat trap, and he was prepared for his death because he tried level best to come out of it, but it became quite dark and he was not able, and he thought that he would die. And then he heard the iron strokes from Ramcho Ironworks. With that, we come to our next question. Describe the Ramcho Ironworks. It was a large plant with a smelter and all. Then there were barges and stores, the flat bottom boat outside. Then the canal which brought the boats there. Then the roads which had become black. Then inside there was the forge where the furnace was there. Inside the furnace burned the coal. In the coal, among the coal pieces, burning coal pieces, there was a piece of pig iron kept. The bellows, the pipes, they brought the air in, and the fire boy shoveled the charcoal into the coal. Then when the pig iron became hot, two people were working there, blacksmith and the helper. So one of them brought the pig iron, holding it with the tongs. Then they kept it on the anvil. One sat there close to the anvil, holding it with the tongs. The other used to beat it with the hammer. So this is the description of the iron mill. Then the next question, why did the blacksmith not notice the peddler coming inside? Because there were many noises. The big bellows were groaning, the charcoal was cracking, the fire boy was shoveling charcoal into the maw of the furnace. Then there was a waterfall, the north wind and the rain. So because of this, he did not notice. Then the blacksmith, did he allow this man, the peddler, to remain inside the forge? He said it was okay. Many people came. If this was a vagabond who has come, he allowed him. Then came the owner of the iron mill, and he is the iron master. What was the strange incident that happened? The iron master got mistaken him to be Neil Solov. The actual name of Neil Solov, Captain Wansdale. But he thought that it was Captain Wansdale, and he addressed him as pet name Neil Solov. Now, the peddler should have refused that he was not Neil Solov, but he accepted because Sitting in the trap, he wanted more. He thought that if this man is considering me to be his old friend, he might give me some money. He accepted. So the iron master invited him home, which he refused. So with that, we come to our next question. Why did he refuse the invitation of the iron master? The reason, he was not Nils Oluf. So in the bright light in the morning, the iron master would come to know the truth about him. And plus he had those 30 kroners. So he refused. Then we have the next question. What idea do you get about the iron master from this first meeting? We find him to be a very pompous person, a man full of superiority complex. He tells the man that if I had been there, this would not have happened and all these things. And then he invites him home. But his manner of invitation is also very pompous. But the stranger refuses. The next question is, why does he accept Edla's invitation? And the difference between the iron master and the daughter? The first difference we come to know that the daughter had better powers of persuasion. Then the daughter seemed to be modest. And then she invited the peddler. And the invitation was so friendly, so full of compassion. And she made a promise that the peddler would come as a free man, he would go as a free man. Because of this, the peddler accepted the invitation in one go. So this is the answer to the question, why did he accept Edla's invitation? Then the next thing, he did not even thank the blacksmith and went to the iron master's house. Now in the night, he slept in a room, and this side in the morning, the iron master and the daughter were talking. And the iron master said that he was caring also. He said, let us give him some food and let us give him a profitable business. But the daughter said something. She said that it did not seem to her that he was once educated. The iron master said that maybe because of the clothes, he did not seem educated. With the change of clothes, they would see somebody else. And obviously they saw somebody else because he was expecting Nils Oluf. But he saw he was another person and he did a mistake. Now, what did the peddler say in his defense? He should have asked sorry. Instead of that, he blamed the iron master for bringing him there. And plus, he said that nothing wrong had been done. He could wear his rags and go away. Then it is here that the iron master threatens to call the police, and then he starts to show him philosophy. It is then where we ended the last session, and that was the previous session, and that was where he asked the peddler to move out. And then something astonishing happens again. This chapter is full of very strange reactions that we'll discuss once more towards the last. And one strange reaction is, he asked the peddler to go, but Edla stopped the peddler. She interceded for the peddler. Interceded is to when you speak on somebody's behalf. And here is where you find something strange, and maybe this touched the peddler's heart. So let's begin from here. But just as the man was opening the door, the daughter said, I think you ought to stay with us today. If you have understood, we are doing para number 4 here. So just see. As the man was opening the door, the daughter said, I think he ought to stay with us today. I don't want him to go. And with that, she went and closed the door. What in the world are you doing? Said the father. The daughter stood there quite embarrassed and hardly knew what to answer. Embarrassed because she was going all against her father just because of a stranger. But why did she intercede for the peddler? Do you think so? It was that promise that she had said that he'll come as a free man, he'll go as a free man. But he was going as a free man. But that cannot be the answer. The answer is something else. So here comes a very important question. What was the reason that Edla interceded for the peddler? You'll find here 3 points. So let us see you're able to identify them before I tell you. So let's see. The daughter stood there quite embarrassed and hardly knew what to answer. That morning, she had felt so happy when she thought how home-like and Christmassy she was going to make things for the poor, hungry wretch. She could not get away from the idea all at once. And that was why she had interceded for the vagabond. If you have got the answer, 1 point is here. Students, it's just like this, that your parents have said that you're able to celebrate or you'll celebrate your birthday. And by afternoon, they say, no, today you just call it off and you'll not be allowed to celebrate. Will you be able to take that idea all at once out of your mind? It's so tough. We can't do it because we have made up our mind. We think of a party. We think of what all arrangements we'd make. We've already thought of it. So it's very easy to take ideas out of our mind so abruptly and so suddenly. Now, from the morning, this girl had thought that she would give a very good Christmas to this poor man. So now she could not take that idea all at once out of her mind. So this was the first reason that made her intercede for the peddler. Then the same thing, see the second reason. I'm thinking of the stranger here, said the young girl. He walks the whole year long
And there's probably not a single place in the whole country where he is welcome and can feel at home. Wherever he turns, he is chased away. Anyway, always he is afraid of being arrested and cross-examined. I should like to have him enjoy a day of peace with us here, just one in the whole year. This is where you find a very generous person, Edla was. She said that at least the whole year he cannot celebrate. Once in a year at the time of Christmas, can't we give him a very good Christmas? This is, see, we talk about Christmas, it means hope, faith and charity. And was she not showing charity here? Yes, she wanted to show charity for a poor, hungry man. And this is the second point. Let's see the next one. The ironmaster mumbled something in his beard, and this clearly shows he could not oppose his daughter. He could not bring himself to oppose her. It was all a mistake, of course, she continued. But anyway, I don't think we ought to chase away a human being whom we have asked to come here and to whom we have promised Christmas cheer. See, it is just like this. You call somebody for lunch or dinner, and when the person comes, you say, we are going out for dinner. You manage whatever you can. This is not an invitation. When we invite somebody, we have to properly treat that person. She said, we have invited this person for Christmas happiness. It would be so bad and humiliating if today we say that you go away. So at least one day of Christmas, let him enjoy. So I think so all of you have got the reason. The first reason is that she could not take the idea out of her mind all at once. The second reason is that she wanted to have one, at least one day of peace at the time of Christmas. And the third, she said that it would be very bad if we chase away somebody whom we have invited for Christmas happiness. So the three reasons you are getting. Now the ironmaster did not say anything, but in a sarcastic manner, he said something. You do preach worse than a parson, said the ironmaster. Said, you preach worse than a parson. A parson preaches, maybe he does not practice. But you're preaching also and you're practicing also. So you're worse than a parson. He said this in a sarcastic manner. And then he said something which is an example of verbal irony. Why? I'll tell you one page after. But you have to see this line and underline it. I only hope you won't have to regret this, he said. I don't think so that afterwards you'll have to regret this. Then the young girl took the stranger by the hand and led him up to the table. Now sit down and eat, she said. For she could see that her father had given in. So now you understand who seems to be more dominating between the father and the daughter. You find that the daughter is more dominating. The reason is not her dominating nature or domineering attitude. The reason is her maturity. And see the way she was acting so maturely. She said, we have invited him. He should remain here. Okay. Then the man with the rat trap said not a word. He only sat down and helped himself to the food. Time after time, he looked at the young girl who had interceded for him. You're getting the word here, interceded? Why had she done it? What could the crazy idea be? After that, Christmas Eve at Ramsgrove Pass just said it always had. Students, here you'll find that this man did nothing but sleep for the whole day. And you'll understand for many years, maybe he must not have slept as properly as here. So I'll read this paragraph. The stranger did not cause any trouble because he did nothing but sleep. The whole forenoon, he lay on the sofa in one of the guest rooms and slept at one stretch. See, here you have to notice something. Now she knows the truth of the peddler. She knows that he is a peddler, not a captain. He could be made to stay anywhere in the house, but he was made to stay in the guest rooms. He was sleeping on the sofa. That means, did they give a treatment as they would have given to a captain? Yes. At noon, they woke him up so that he could have his share of the good Christmas fare. But after that, he slept again. It seemed as though for many years he had not been able to sleep as quietly and safely as here at Ramsgrove. In the evening, when the Christmas tree was lighted, they woke him up again and he stood for a while in the drawing room blinking as though the candlelight hurt him. But after that, he disappeared again. 2 hours later, he was aroused once more. He then had to go down into the dining room and eat the Christmas fish and porridge. So you can understand every time, but was he woken up? It's not that they made him sleep. And after that, they never cared that he should get up and eat something. Time to time, he was woken up. He was given proper food. Again, he slept. Again, given proper food. Again, he slept. This is how things are. He was given a very proper treatment. Then, at the time of when the Christmas tree was lighted, he did something unusual. What is that? As soon as they got up from the table, he went around to each one present and said, thank you and good night. Now, earlier he had said thank you to the crofter. He did not mean it. He did not say thank you to the blacksmith.
He did not say thank you even to the iron master who called him to his house. He rather blamed him. And now he is telling everyone thank you whom he doesn't even know. So this is strange. Okay, said thank you and good night. But when he came to the young girl, she gave him to understand that it was her father's intention that the suit which he wore was to be a Christmas present. He did not have to return it. And if he wanted to spend next Christmas Eve in a place where he could rest in peace and be sure that no evil would befall him, he would be welcomed back again. A very great gesture from Edla. She said that if he wanted to spend one more Christmas, the next Christmas also, he was welcome. The man with the rat traps did not answer anything to this. He only stared at the young girl with boundless amazement. He was surprised. He was shocked like anything. And that surprise was boundless, no limit. The next morning, the ironmaster and his daughter got up in good season. You're getting the expression again? Getting up early. To go to the early Christmas service. Their guest was still asleep and they did not disturb him. Now the story is coming towards its end. But see, the strange incident would happen. When at about 10 o'clock they drove back from the church, the young girl sat and hung her head even more dejectedly than usual. Her head was hung. The reason? The father was scolding her. Scolding her for what? Just see. At church, she had learned that one of the old crofters of the ironworks had been robbed by a man who went around selling rat traps. Now we understand that the man whom they had made to stay in the house, she in fact had made to stay in the house, was not only a peddler, he was also a robber. He was a thief. Yes, that was a fine fellow you let into the house. You're getting that thing. I told you about verbal irony. The father had said, I don't think you afterwards you'll have to regret this. Was the daughter regretting? Yes, sometimes words come true like this, students. That's why we should be very careful with words. We never know when our words can come true. The father said, I hope you won't have to regret this. And was she regretting? Yes. So in our life, we should be careful with which words we speak. Then, I only wonder how many silver spoons are left in the cupboard by this time. He was so materialistic, he was worried about the silver spoons of his house, because now he knew that they have left a robber in the house. He could steal anything and go. Now what happened when they reached the house? The wagon had hardly stopped in the front steps when the ironmaster asked the valet whether the stranger was still there. He added that he had heard at church that the man was a thief. The valet answered that the fellow had gone and that he had not taken anything with him at all. On the contrary, he had left behind a little package which Miss Wilmanson was to be kind enough to accept as a Christmas present. Did he get full chance of stealing everything? Yes. Did he steal? No. On the contrary, he has left a gift. Students, here is an important point of our life. We all like to accept gifts. But do we experience the same happiness when we have to give gifts? Maybe no. Sometimes one gift which we have received from some other place, pack it again and give it to somebody else. So this has happened many times. Act of receiving is good. Act of giving sometimes is not so good for us. Has the peddler now learned to give? Yes, because he left a gift for Edla. What was that gift? With that, we come to the end of the chapter. Let's see what was the gift. The young girl opened the package, which was so badly done up that the contents came into view at once. She gave a little cry of joy. She found a small rat trap, and in it lay 3 wrinkled 10 kroner notes. But that was not all. In the rat trap lay also a letter written in large jagged characters. Some people say, ma'am, you said the peddler is not educated. I said not educated, but he was literate enough to write a letter. There's a difference between literacy and education. So he wrote a letter. And you must have seen, the important thing is those 30 kroner notes were kept there in that rat trap. And plus a letter. That letter is important. Honored and noble miss, since you have been so nice to me all day long, as if I was a captain, I want to be nice to you in return, as if I was a real captain. You were good to me, as though I was a captain. I want to be good to you, as though I am a captain. For I do not want you to be embarrassed at this Christmas season by a thief, but you can give back the money to the old man on the roadside who has the money pouch hanging on the window frame as a bait for poor wanderers. The rat trap is a Christmas present from a rat who would have been caught in this world's rat trap if he had not been raised to captain, because in that way he got power to clear himself. Written with friendship and high regard, Captain Von's Tale, and that was not his name, but he signed the letter as Captain Von's Tale. The reason is very clear. He had been raised to the status of a captain. This is where this particular story ends. Now we understand that was the peddler able to come out of the rat trap? Yes, he was able to. But there are many who don't wish even to come out of this rat trap. But towards the last, it was Edla's goodness which transformed this man, and he was able to come out of the rat trap. So I think so you have now understood the whole story. And in this particular case, in the NCERT questions, you need to be very careful regarding the NCERT questions here. These are maximum 6-mark questions, and many of them have come in the board exams also. So let us see the first one. How does the peddler interpret the act of kindness and hospitality shown by the crofter, the ironmaster and his daughter? We have to write about 3. How did he interpret the acts of kindness and hospitality? Crofter. Was the crofter good to this man? Yes. When nobody invites a vagabond inside the house, the crofter invited the vagabond, then served him, gave him food to eat, shared his secrets. What did he do with that goodness of the crofter? He robbed his hard-earned money. Okay. Then ironmaster. Did the ironmaster show goodness to him? Yes. He invited him home. When he did not come, he sent his daughter. All these things. What did he do with the same ironmaster? He started to blame him, started to show him philosophy. But why was the reason that Edla's goodness, Edla was good to him like the other two, but the other two's goodness did not touch his heart? The reason? Crofter was good because he wanted to share his happiness with somebody. He had his reasons. Iron Master was good because whatever he was doing for his friend. Edla did for a poor peddler, and that was a selfless goodness. That's why this selfless goodness touched his heart. So when you write this answer, you have to write it properly. Then the second question, what are the instances in the story that show the characters of the ironmaster is different from that of his daughter? I've already discussed. One is better parts of persuasion. One is ironmaster seemed to be pompous. Daughter was modest. Then the ironmaster's invitation was full of pompous superiority. Daughter's invitation was friendly and modest. Then the daughter interceded for him. Every time she was more mature, she had better observation skills. These all things you have to write in the second question. And plus at the same time, give examples from the text. Then the third one. The story has many instances of unexpected reactions. Now this is important. Unexpected reactions right from the beginning. First, the philosophy comes to a peddler. That is unexpected. Then the next thing, if you talk about reactions, crofter, he knocked the door of a crofter's house. Expected that nobody would welcome him. The crofter welcomed him. First unexpected reaction. Second, he knew that the money was hard earned. He should not have stole. He stole the money. Then third was when the truth of his, his truth was revealed. No, sorry. Unexpected reaction is when he came down and the ironmaster was astonished that he is not Nils Oluf. That time he should have asked sorry, but he started to show philosophy and blame the ironmaster. Then next unexpected reaction is when he told thank you and Merry Christmas to everyone present. And the last unexpected reaction is when he could have full chance of stealing everything. He left those 30 kroners and left a letter and came out of the rat trap. So all these instances are there. Then what made the peddler finally change his ways? It was Edla's goodness. Then you have to write. Then question number 5. How does the metaphor of the rat trap serve to highlight the human predicament? Predicament means difficult situation. Does it serve to highlight the human being's difficult situation? Yes. In difficult situations, only people do wrong. Did he do wrong? Yes. But when situations came to normal and in his favor, he again came out of the rat trap. Then the peddler comes out as a person with a subtle sense of humor. Yes, because he comes up with a philosophy, and then at the same time, he shows the philosophy to the ironmaster also. See, these all things will come. So this is all you have to be very careful about this particular story. And I'll bring your attention to talking about the text question number 2 also. The story also focuses on human loneliness. Are all the characters in the chapter lonely? Peddler, lonely. Crofter, lonely. Ironmaster and Edla had company of each other. They were not alone. But were they lonely? Yes. That's why he invited his friend to his house over Christmas. And she stopped him at the time of Christmas. So all characters in the story are lonely. So you have, and do they need to bond with each other? Yes. And this bonding only transforms people. So this is the end of this particular chapter. Thank you.